Whenever I'm in New York, I try to seek up my commercial husband, Jonathan. So maybe just contextualize that a bit. Jonathan is a salesman who works at Brooks Brothers down in Financial District. He knows my inseam measurements, and also every time I try to, when I will buy a suit, I'll try to seek out Jonathan. And then afterwards, of course, I'll go home to my real life wife and ask her what she thinks about the suit, that is. My name is David, and I will talk to you about e-commerce. So just like my commercial husband, Jonathan, the one who's actually making the sale is the one that has the relationship with me as a customer. You as OEMs do not, most of the time. It is the salesperson that knows, can anticipate my needs and know which type of products that attracts me. The old way of selling is that really you have someone else selling the products for you. And best chance, you as an OEM, you can have a distance sort of monologue towards the customer. But you also risk slipping down the value chain, basically have no brand loyalty, and actually in the end, if the retailers start making your products as well, you become obsolete as an OEM. The first advice that I would like to give in order to create this relationship, this marriage that you can do with e-commerce is actually it's quite controversial. It's actually to scrap your old way of working. Scrap your legacy systems, your processes, and your basically your organizational setup. However, that's controversial. I know you're dependent on your processes and your systems, your beloved SAP, etc., to generate cash and stay afloat. But if you don't make this change to this new way of doing commerce, selling direct to your customers, other companies will do, and in the end make you obsolete again. You can do a bunch of reprocessing, etc., but the best way is actually just to scrap it and start over. But let's say you guys agree with me and let's do e-commerce. But just in the same way as a normal physical store, your e-commerce store still needs a sign on the door. Customers need to know where you are, know to locate you. They need to be dragged in a bit with adverts and offers. But if you just have a perfectly beautiful, well-operating store with no sign on the door, you'll basically vanish in the market and become obsolete again. Doing all this, there's one part of your current or old business that will fight back, and that is your current retailer, your business partner that is actually selling your products for you. This is a fight that many companies are quite afraid to take, but I'm really saying that you need to take this fight, because the retailer as such has much less to lose in this fight than you as an OEM. They might lose some share of their market, but you basically, as I said, vanish and become obsolete. Again, what I'm recommending is that you can either patch and try to reprocess for years, might bleed your company dry with investments, etc. But the best way is actually to start from scratch. And how do you do that? You could start an own separate, a new legal entity, and try to start with that company from scratch. Build your process, your systems, etc. around this new direct selling, direct customer relationship. Your old business might still be there on the side, but it will slowly sort of deteriorate and lose importance, and you can move over to your new way of business model. So it's quite controversial, but in essence, what I'm saying is that either you make your old business obsolete yourself, or someone else will. Thank you very much.